Quarantine restrictions in the so-called NCR Plus bubble has been eased. President Rodrigo Duterte has approved placing Metro Manila, Laguna, and Rizal under the general community quarantine classification, but with heightened restrictions starting this weekend until the end of May. Under the new classification, only essential travel in and out of the NCR Plus areas will be allowed. Indoor dine-in services are also permitted at 20% capacity, outdoor dining at 50%. Now, outdoor tourist attractions can be open at 30% capacity as well. But entertainment venues like bars, amusement parks, as well as indoor sports and tourist attractions are still prohibited to operate. Religious gatherings and gatherings for necrological services and funerals, on the other hand, are allowed at 10% of the venue's capacity. The government first placed Metro Manila and nearby areas under modified enhanced community quarantine, the second strictest lockdown on April 12. That's due to a rise in COVID-19 infections in those areas. Cases have declined since, but some hospitals have said that's not enough to ease restrictions.
We're hoping that it will drop further. You know, we're still in the high 100. So, and it's only been about 7 days since we reached the less than 200 mark. One thing, though, is we are seeing less and less walk-in visits in the emergency room, meaning less COVID patients in the ER, although we still take care of a lot of the severe and critically ill patients, and so our ICUs are still full.
Halos wala na po mga pila sa emergency room at medyo decongested na yung mga COVID beds.
Oo.
At minsan dun sa medyo critical pa rin po yung mga ICU beds. Mm.
Meanwhile, Zamboanga City as well as three other areas are under modified enhanced community quarantine due to rising COVID-19 cases there. Zamboanga City in particular has called for an extension of its MECQ period as infections continue to overwhelm its healthcare system. Puerto Princesa, which has also recorded high cases, however, has been placed under general community quarantine along with several other areas. The rest of the country, meanwhile, is under the loosest modified GCQ. The Octa Research Group says COVID-19 infections in the Philippines declined by 16% rather. But the group says that it's not a reason to be complacent as infections remain high compared to the first time the country experienced a peak in cases in August last year. The country on Thursday logged 6,385 new cases, the highest in 3 days. Active cases also went up for the first time in a week and now stands at 55,260. The Philippines also eases more restrictions even in areas under the second strictest quarantine level. In-person assessments for household service workers are now allowed even in areas under modified enhanced community quarantine. But the interagency task force says the in-person assessments will be permitted only in training institutions under the Technical Education and Skills Development Authority or TESDA. They remain prohibited in private assessment centers. They will also be limited to household service workers who already have contracts and visas. Meanwhile, the IATF also approved the selling of lotto tickets nationwide, even in areas under modified enhanced community quarantine. These lotto tickets must be recognized by the Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office, or PCSO, and its authorized agents. The PCSO is directed to ensure strict compliance to health and safety protocols. The Philippines extends its ban on travelers from India until the end of May to arrest the spread of the COVID-19 variant first detected in this country. It also added two more countries to the travel ban, Oman and the United Arab Emirates. Starting May 15 until the 31st, those with travel history to these two countries within the last 14 days are not allowed in the Philippines. Passengers already in transit will be required to undergo strict quarantine and testing protocols. The Philippines earlier this week detected its first two cases of the more transmissible variant from India on two Filipinos who arrived from these two countries. The province of Cebu temporarily closing its international airport to returning overseas Filipino workers. Governor Gwen Garcia says the Mactan Cebu International Airport will not accept passengers from today, May 14 to May 15, as quarantine facilities for returning OFWs have reached full capacity. But Garcia gave assurances that flights will resume once they get a go signal from the agencies manning the facilities. Garcia has also signed a measure requiring negative COVID-19 tests for returning overseas Filipino workers and those who will pass by Cebu from their connecting flights. Cebu is currently under modified general community quarantine with 517 active cases in the province. The Philippines is set to receive 7 million COVID-19 vaccine doses this month. Vaccine Chief Carlito Galvez Jr. says this includes the 2.2 million Pfizer doses from the World Health Organization's COVAX facility. The Philippines was initially set to receive just half of that number until Pfizer offered to give more doses. The Philippines will also get 500,000 more Sinovac shots and 1.3 million Sputnik V doses this month. For June, the government is expecting to receive more than 10 million doses, including the AstraZeneca and Moderna vaccines that were ordered by the private sector.
We will distribute the vaccines as fast as they come to our possession. So maghintay lang kayo because these things must be distributed immediately. The fastest way that we can do it. So yun ang tandaan ninyo na mabilis na ang dating ngayon at mabilis din ang bigay natin. Mabilis pagpasok, bilis din tayo magpalabas sa inyo.
Meanwhile, the Philippine Food and Drug Administration hopes to finish evaluating Sinopharm's application for emergency use next week. FDA Director General Eric Domingo says the Health Department met with Sinopharm representatives on Thursday to discuss the vaccine's clinical trial data.